all we have to do is just drag and drop the MP3s into WALTR, and that's it. It was that fast. Less than, I don't know, a second. Hi everyone, my name is Josh, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how to transfer MP3s to your iPod Classic. I have an iPod Classic, 160 gigs right here. They're no longer sold, they're pretty much outdated, and it's 2018 right now, coming to 2019. People don't even use these iPods anymore. I don't think that we should give up on them. These are awesome, and I think one of the best music players out there. They have a lot of space, and they have great quality. iTunes no longer provides maintenance of your iPod Classic. They discontinued them, and watch this tutorial and you'll get your MP3s onto your iPod Classic in no time. Now, this also works if you go to your friend's house who has, you know, a big music library of MP3 files and you have your iPod. It can be your iPod Classic, Shuffle, Nano, whatever. You can just connect it to your friend's computer, whether it's a PC or a Mac, get the solution that I'm gonna show you right here, and transfer all of those MP3 files into your iPod without iTunes, without a hassle. It's just drag and drop. So let me show you what we're actually going to do. We're gonna take our iPod Classic and we're gonna put it down on the table for now. The solution is called WALTR 2, and I'm actually one of the guys behind it. It's free to download, so first things first, open up your internet browser, whether on your Mac or a PC. Go on softorino.com/WALTR. I'm gonna leave the link in the description below and click on free download. It's a paid app for a lifetime license, but you get 24 hours of unlimited, unrestricted use. So just click on free download and you'll be able to get WALTR to use it and transfer MP3 files into your iPod Classic without iTunes. So you'll get, you know, instructions on how to install it for Mac and for Windows. After you're done with that, open up the installation file or the DMG file, install it, and this is a screen you're gonna encounter, okay? It's a simple box which will ask you to connect your iPhone, iPad, or iPod via USB. So I'm gonna take my USB right here, I'm gonna take my iPod, and after I open up WALTR, I'm gonna connect my iPod. So now we just wait until WALTR recognizes it. Okay, it recognizes it. As you can see right here, it's like a little flash drive. That's what Macs do. They show up, they show your iPod Classic as a flash drive. In any case, so we have these MP3 files that we want to transfer to our iPod Classic, right? It doesn't have any music right now. And what we're going to do is transfer MP3 files into our iPod Classic without iTunes. All we have to do is just drag and drop the MP3s into WALTR. And that's it. It was that fast. Less than, I don't know, a second, right? It's done when you see like a green check mark. All you have to do is just disconnect your iPod. You can click on like on your flash drive like this, eject. Bam, that's it. Disconnect it. And now I'm gonna show you, I don't have a camera, I'm just gonna show you what exactly is going inside the iPod. But as you can see, you go into music, songs, and you see these particular two songs, as you've seen on the screen right here, they're now transferred, okay? And they play back seamlessly. Look, they have the artwork and everything. Okay, it was that easy. All you have to do is download WALTR, drag and drop your MP3s, and they will show up. iPhone, your iPad, your iPod Classic, whatever. Best of all, it works not only with MP3s, but also FLAC files, ALAC files, like any audio format that's not even supported by iTunes, WALTR can take it. Go on Google, whatever. Search WALTR, WALTR, look up for some reviews, see what you, see what others think, what, you know, the media thinks, and, you know, make the decision. We received a lot of great responses, so we're confident that our solution is the best and probably the only solution that actually provides such an easy drag and drop interface for this solution. I hope this tutorial helped you get MP3 files on your iPod Classic without iTunes. I hope you can share it with your friends. If you have questions, if you have trouble, be sure to leave them in comments below and I'll get back to you. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.